We've spent a lot of time in the show talking about political division. But if Republicans and Democrats can agree on one thing, it's this.
We're gathered together today to address America's drug and opioid crisis. And a crisis it is, which now claims 70,000 lives a year.
That was Donald Trump less than 2 weeks ago announcing a new bipartisan law aimed at stemming the addiction crisis, which recent data from the CDC shows might be slowing ever so slightly. Overdose deaths were down nearly 3% in 2018 after hitting record highs the 2 years prior, meaning we might be at the beginning of the end of the crisis. So why then would the FDA approve a new drug that might be the beginning of the end of life for many suffering from addiction? It's a synthetic opioid called Dysuvia, the pill form of a painkiller given to surgery patients and women giving birth. It's 1,000 times stronger than morphine and 10 times stronger than fentanyl. 10 times stronger than fentanyl, the opioid responsible for more than half of opioid deaths in 2017. As Senator Ed Markey put it, an opioid that is 1,000 times more powerful than morphine is 1,000 times more likely to be abused and 1,000 times more likely to kill. Dysuvia is expected to hit the market by early next year. And while the FDA has stressed that its use will be heavily restricted, I have to point out that other opioids are supposed to be restricted too, and obviously they're still making it onto the black market. Thankfully, though, FDA Commissioner Scott Gottlieb looks like he might be having second thoughts. After criticism poured in, he issued an unusual statement saying, quote, "I believe that we should consider whether we should be doing more to evaluate each candidate opioid." No kidding. Anyone who could have told you that, including Dr. Laura Kehoe. She's the director of the Substance Use Disorder Bridge Clinic at Mass General, who recently joined me on the issue.
It goes back to deep-rooted stigma in multi-levels of the medical community, the government. The medical community really needs to look, have introspection on how we've managed it.
Dr. Kehoe is obviously right. Now's the time we should be scaling back the way we produce and prescribe highly addictive and lethal drugs, not add another, even more lethal one into the mix.